And let's get into it. Right after these tunes.
Yeah, is my mic working well?
Yeah, bro, your mic's working fine, bud.
Okay, good.
So this is the second time I think I'm micing you. Hold on, Chelsea just messaged me, okay? Shit, good luck. All right, whatever. Okay. Shit, I don't even know how to start this. So. Fucking, is that a scooter in the back?
Yeah, it is. I'm outside.
Yeah. I heard somebody riding a scooter. I'm actually outside, too. I'm inside, but I'm outside. So, like, I don't know if that makes sense. Because I like to smoke or something when I'm doing one of these podcast sessions and shit. So, yeah. So, what's going on, Zolly? How's your day going today?
My day is going just fine. What about yours?
I'm doing all right, little sis. Should I call you sister? Should I call you Zolly, Zolrac, Zolita? What do you want me to call you? Just whatever?
Yeah, you can call me whatever you want.
All right. So I know that me and you have been talking on and off on XAT for a couple of years. I remember when I saw you on XAT. I can't even remember when. It was fucking before the pandemic, before that shit started. And I know you were really new to XAT. I didn't know you that well. I mean, I still don't, and I don't really like to get personal. I just keep it strictly related to XAT. You know what I mean? The questions. So if I do end up asking you something and you don't want to say it, you don't have to say it. You know what I mean? I'll respect your privacy. So
I'm an open book. So I can answer just about anything.
Right. So, you know, let me ask you, how old were you when you first came on XAT?
I was like 8 years old.
You were 8 years old?
Yeah, I was.
Okay, how old are you now?
I'm 18.
You're 18, so you were 8 years old when you got on XAT. So where, if you don't mind me asking this question, did your parents know that you were using XAT at 8 years old?
They somewhat did. They didn't really care. Like, they knew I was on chats where, like, most people were my age. There were times I went to chats like Flirt when it was still on, like, the featured groups. Okay. So, like, yeah, they somewhat knew.
So your parents knew about it, but let me ask you, when you were young, did your parents know the type of website XAT was and things that went on? Well, yeah, go ahead.
Soon enough, they did. Like, they didn't see anything wrong with it at the time.
Right, because I know that every XAT chat was different. Some were moderated, so I get it. It was fine to be there because of the content. And you
yeah,
were
I
really
was on Vantage Chats.
You were on what chat?
Vantage Chats.
Okay. Was it moderated? Were there mods in there and they had rules?
Yeah, they did. Because it was like, Vantage was a site like Club Penguin, so there were like a lot of kids on there. So yeah, it was heavily moderated.
Right. And so you were 8 years old, you came to XAT, you're 18 years old now, you said. So what age were, like, how old were you when you came on Flirt?
Oh yeah, I was 8 as well when I came to Flirt. It was like maybe 5 months after I first joined and I went on there. And I was like, what the fuck is this shit?
Right, right. Because you know that chat didn't have any moderators or no admins were present. So you were 8 years old and you were on Flirt. So
yeah, the first thing I came across was somebody, they drew a dick on Doodle. And I was like,
right. Okay. So like, I don't understand. Like, You were, so you, your parents didn't notice anything that you're on XAT with all, you know, like, what the fuck? You know, like.
No, because I had my own, like, laptop, my own personal laptop. They never, like, checked my shit. But they knew I was on there. They just didn't care.
Right. Right. Okay. I totally hear you. Shit. So, like, I don't know, like, because this is just really, like, I don't know how to respond to that. Like, damn, you're 8 years old and you're using XAT and you're on Flirt. Like, everything is wrong with that. If you just look at the picture, everything is wrong with that. Like, I know that if you were my daughter or you were my sister, little sister or something, I wouldn't even let you use the computer, bro. Like, I'd be like, bro, no computer for you. You should be fucking not be on that shit. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, looking back, it was pretty fucking weird to think about.
Because I'm 31, right? I came in my teenager's day, like when I was teens. Like, okay, it was fine to be on Flirt. But someone who's fucking 8 years old, like, that shit's not fucking cool, bro. Like, you shouldn't be on Flirt at all. So, I mean, I don't mean to be rude, but I think your parents should have been, you know, really seeing the type of websites you're on and what you're doing. Because there's no fucking way an 8-year-old should be on Flirt chat. Because I know the type of chat that is. I know everything, the ins and outs. I know so much about that chat because I've been there for so long. People that been on the podcast, they've been on that chat for a couple of years. But you're 18 years old now and you're still on Flirt. So can you share some of your good and bad experiences, the things that have happened while you were on Flirt chat?
Yeah, I can. I mean, there was, like, a lot of cool people on there. Like, not everyone was, like, a pedo. There were some people who didn't actually, like, believe my age. And they would, like, ask me to get on cam. But, like, I didn't do that. I just mic. I think my first experience on Flirt was with Michael, Greg named Freeze, I think it was.
How old was Michael? If you don't mind me asking.
I don't know. I think he was 16,
17, 18. Okay. And you were just friends with Michael. Right. Yeah, Zolly, can you hold on a second?
Calling random ass people in there.
Can you hold on for a minute? I got a phone call coming, so just hold on.
Okay.
Yo, just give me a minute. All right. We're going to go on a commercial break. For a minute or two, we're going to come right back and continue the rest of this episode.
Straight madness, right? Straight madness. I'm going to try to get on. I'm going to try to get on and see if I get, like, my voice on Spotify, y'all. XAT Podcast. XATPodcast.com. Welcome to Spotify, y'all. Okay, don't fill up my PC. Yes, that is real. It's a clean link, y'all. Go to Spotify. Check it out on Spotify. Everybody's like clicking on me. Don't click on me. I just got told. I just clicked the link. I checked it myself, y'all. XATPodcast.com. It's just madness, right? You thought it was over? Man, funk that. Next level, y'all. Time to get the podcast on. Tell everybody how much fun you're having in XAT, y'all. It's on Spotify.
Why did it take so long? Why did I wait so long, huh? To figure it out, but I did it. And I'm the only one underneath the sun who didn't get it. I can't believe that I could be deceived. By my so-called girl, but in reality, had a hidden agenda. She put my gender all in a blender.
All right, can you hear me?
Yep.
Yeah, sorry about that. It was a personal phone call. Okay, so you were saying you met a 16-year-old. You were talking about a guy who was 16. I'll edit this shit out, so it's not a problem. But you want to go back to what you were saying? Or if you forgot?
Oh, yeah. He was like... I mean, this was 2012, so most people were in their, like, teens at least still. I was like, most of the people online now were, like, in their mid-20s and shit, but...
Right.
I were about, like, 16,
17, 18. So, Zolly, like, go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
On that tiny chat, my first experience on there, I met someone named and that dude's fucking old as shit. So, he basically went over there.
Right.
And, like, a few years later, like, is a really weird ass fuck. This was maybe 2016. He made me add him on Snapchat. And he was posting the person I was dating at the time's last name and shit on Flirt. So he made me add him on Snapchat. And he's like, "For now on, you have to call me Sir, or else I'm gonna send your nudes to your boyfriend." And it's like, what the fuck?
Okay, what the fuck? Like, wait, your nudes? Like, okay, let's just go back. How old were you when Danny joined. Danny's just chilling. She's actually part of Flirt. She's good people, by the way, Zolly. I don't know if you know her. So just disregard. Danny could be here, right? That's cool, Zolly?
Yep.
Okay. So... how old were you when this guy was saying things about your nudes? Like, what was your age? Like,
so I met him on a tiny chat when I was like 9. He just sat there and lurked. And then, like, in 2016, when I was 13, he was like saying that shit, saying, "You're getting to be grown into a full developed teenager," and all that shit, and sending me like jerk off vids and all that shit on Snapchat. I'm just like, what the fuck? So, yeah. Pretty fucking...
What's the name again? I'm sorry. The black guy?
Yeah. The guy with the
finger
tube. Definitely a weirdo. Definitely a weirdo.
All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, Danny just joined the episode number 10 for the podcast. So I'm just going to break it down. Really, I'm sure Danny could hear the beginning. Zolly said she was 8 years old when she joined XAT. She's 18 years old now. She said that there was a guy, you know, I remember Zolly when she was like 15, I was on Flirt and I was like, "Zolly, you shouldn't be on XAT. You're like a little sister to me. You got to be careful." Cause I know the type of shit Flirt chat is. I've been there since 2008. I'm 31 now. I've seen it all. Been there. I've done it all. I mean, I've seen all the fucking drama and shit. But when it came to like pedophilia, like pedos on Flirt, and I talked about Doc with this on the first episode, there were a lot of young girls being pedo'd in 2008, 2010. There was nudes getting exposed. All of this fucking shit was going on, right? And I know there was a lot of complaints. People made tickets. Nothing, like, a lot of things went unanswered. You know, like, what I'm trying to say is, like, it's not all of that is bad. We're just talking about Flirt chat, everything pertaining to Flirt, right? There's no mods in the room. There's no admins. So you got all this fucked up shit going on and nothing was being done about it. So how do you feel about that, Zolly? I want to know, like, how do you feel about that in your words?
I mean, they're easy to avoid, but it's pretty fucking creepy. Because, like, that is that. You can be anonymous and be, like, saying the grossest ass shit. And doing the weirdest ass shit. And I'm just like... like, I've seen some fucked up shit on there. I was literally sent fucking kitty porn by somebody. And, like, that's the type of people that are on there. And it's fucking disgusting.
All right, Zolly. So, in the beginning, I asked you about your parents. And you said your parents knew that you were on XAT at 8 years old, right? So, look. And you said they were kind of okay with it. I mean, my parents, if I was 8, I guess they would have been okay because they would see that some chats, well, most chats were moderated. It was only Flirt Chat that didn't have any admins and mods. There used to be Grid, right? You remember Grid back in the day and photos would pop up? Like, I would see fucked up shit. I would see, like, fucking, you know, I'm looking at the grid. I'm talking to fucking people on the chat. Like fucking Adult Baby and fucking Cassius and Ida James and some fucking weirdo would come on with some fucking fucked up kitty shit on the grid. And, you know, someone actually reported that. They made a ticket. They went to Zad Help. They complained. They made a fucking ticket. And later on, I spoke to this person. I'm like, what happened with the ticket? And, you know, he said nothing really happened. They didn't do anything about it. Like, I just think that was fucked up. You know, when it came to fucking pedophilia and all this pedo talk and all that shit happening on Flirt, they should have fucking at least done something about that. You know, all right, talk is fine, all that shit, but you're going to talk, you're going to do shit like that. I think that should have been addressed. I don't know why it was not. I don't know why Zat tickets went unanswered. I don't know what happened. I'm assuming maybe that's why they had a fucking database leak in 2015 where people's shit got, you know, exposed, like emails and information and all that shit. But Flirt Chat was fucked up, bro. Like, it was fucked up. 2008, I stepped my foot in on Flirt. I came from fucking emo chat. I got doxxed. My shit went out. My social media, people had photos of my mother. I'm like, bro, what the fuck? And since then, I've been like fucking... I'm alert. I'm like, yo, I gotta be careful. I don't want to be out there. Like, I got harassed and all that shit. So, and enough about me, Zolly. You know, because I'm gonna edit a lot of this shit. I feel like it needs editing. I remember speaking to you, right, Zolly, a couple of years ago in private chat, right, in Flirt, and you told me that some guy was fucking harassing you. He had your nudes. He had your address. He had your name. He had your social media. And this guy was fucking harassing you. I actually was the on Flirt and you said yes. Do you remember that, right?
Yeah, I do. It's the running Mewtwo and he's still doing that shit to this day.
He's still fucking doing that to you?
Yep. It's okay. It's the guy that would fake as a girl named Nikki. And would constantly tell me I need to go date girls and shit and take nudes with them. He went and fucking doxxed my shit and harassed me on social media. And he's still doing it sometimes. Like, he'll pick a random ass day to, like, go bipolar and do that shit. Like, he'll be harassing this Ren guy that doesn't even fucking get on Zat. He's not a Zat person at all. And the next day, he'll be harassing Willie. And then after that, he'll be harassing me. And it's just fucking annoying.
Okay, so this Ren person, because I know there used to be a girl named Mew, and this fucking guy Ren used to fucking harass and stalk her. I found out from fucking Maddie, this fucking Ren Mew person was a person named Lesbian Nikki. Like, I don't know who the fuck is Lesbian Nikki, bro. But they would constantly message me. I'm like, hey, where's Mew? I'm like, I don't know, dude. Who the fuck are you? You know, I don't know who Lesbian Nikki is. Yo, there's some fucked up people in the chat, bro.
Yeah, it was him and Ella.
Yeah, I'm hearing...
Girl.
So, let me ask you, are there people that you're cool with, like, on Flirt, and, like, you got friends, like, that, you know, that you talk to, maybe outside of Zat? Are there other people on Zat, like, you talk to?
Yeah, I do. I talk to a few people outside of Zat. Like, I'm not gonna really name their names because they already have people fucking with them. Like, I can name like a few, maybe.
Right? Can you drop the names? Like, if you want to, you don't have to. I'm sorry if I'm sounding.
Well,
like
actually, those friends aren't even outside of Zat, but like, I'm friends with like Coke. He's kind of a small friend.
Wait, did you say Coke is a friend?
Yeah, Coke's a friend, but...
Why would you say Koga's a friend if he fucking exposed your nudes when you were underage in his fucking Discord server?
I don't remember him doing that. I remember that was Ella doing that.
No, Ella did that, and I heard Coke also did that. He has a fucking server called Fortland. You fucking expose your nude, and
I didn't see any of my nudes in there from right, him. I only saw them from Ella. I would have like saw pictures.
Well, Ella's a fucking weirdo. You know, Ella fucking has a habit of camming. Like, Ella would go on cam, like, not show his face, and he has like this fucking suit with titties, and he would get people to cam up, and you know. I don't know. She would just fucking do that for her YouTube channel called Rick Productions, where she's fucking, she recorded Willie and fucking Ben and Wheezy. You know, Rick Productions, that's her fucking YouTube channel. So, I mean, I don't really have a problem with Ella. I just think Ella's a fucking nutjob weirdo.
I honestly don't fuck with Ella because when I was like about 13, when I came back to Zat, he would be like saving my selfies and shit and using them. And, like, Sin and Leroy, or whatever her name was, were the ones to, like, report that to me. I'm like, the fuck?
Wait, who reported it? I know. Leroy?
Yeah, Sin and Leroy. They're like, the fuck? This guy's using your picture.
I know Leroy from Emo Chat. Leroy was, I think she was, like, a fucking tranny. I mean, trans or something. Like, I don't know.
No, I don't think she's trans. She is older than most people. She has a kid.
So what's your relationship with Sin? Like, was he like a fucking normal dude? Like, I've heard... So I did a fucking episode one with Doc, right? And Doc was saying that Sin pedo'd on a lot of fucking girls on Zat. Did he ever pedo on you or something?
I mean, every time I join Flirt and Sin's online, he'll, like, bring up my nudes and shit. He'll be like, you slapped your claim for Luca and all of that. Like, I seen your hymen. And it's just like... I've never, he claims I sent him pictures. Like, he says every girl in there sent him pictures, but I never sent him shit. Unless some other tune sent him shit. But, like, the shit he says to me is fucking weird.
Right. Yeah, that's pretty weird.
Like, that's pretty creepy shit. I'm not friends with him outside or on any social media. I never, like, PC him or any of that. The only communication I ever have with him is when he's, like, on main chat of Flirt. I never talk to him anywhere else. I don't fuck with him like that.
Oh, okay. I used to think, because when I remember a couple of years ago, like, I used to be like, yo, Zolly, you're, like, the next Sin because you're, like, so fucking racist. Like, are you racist, Zolly? Like, do you hate, like, fucking... Like, do you hate people? Like, do you hate minorities and shit?
Oh, with my experiences and other people's, I kind of do. That's just how I was, like, raised. Like, I have been, like, nice. Like, I have hung with black people before that aren't, like, obnoxious and shit. Like, I can have normal conversations with them in real life. Like, I'm not going to sit there and call them the N-word.
Do you, like, use the N-word in real life? Like, do you, when you see a black person, do you call them the N-word?
Well, no, I never really been around that many black people in my life, and I was living in Scottsdale. I was, though, but I never, like, called them that.
Okay.
Unless they, so, like, they don't, if they're not doing shit to me, I'm not gonna do that.
Okay, so if you see, like, a black person, and he says, or he or she says hi, or good morning, like, would you call him, like, be like, hey, nigger, what's up, nigger?
That would only be, like, if I was with friends or something, and he was, like, around my age.
Right.
But if it's, like, a normal black guy, no, I wouldn't say that. I would just say hi back and be polite.
So, let me tell you. So, like, I'm half brown. You know that, right? I'm half Puerto Rican, right?
Yeah.
Just want to put that out there. I'm Puerto Rican. I'm white and Jewish. So, like, would you call me, like, a spig, kike, or something, or a beaner? If you saw me?
No, I wouldn't.
Okay. So if I said, hey, Zolly, how you doing? You're not going to call me, you know. You're not going to be like, hey, Jew, what's up? You know, like, you're not going to do that, right?
No, I wouldn't.
Yeah. Okay. So I want to ask you, Zol. I remember you used to have, like, good friendship with Gucci. I don't know if you remember Gucci or not, the one who lives in Mexico. How's your relationship with Gucci, bro?
I used to be, like, best friends with him. We used to, like, troll, flirt a lot and all that. And I used to go to, like, the chats he was in. But, like, we don't really talk that much. he doesn't really use that or Discord anymore. He's like just stays around on social media mostly.
Right. Sorry, I'm smoking this shit right now. Shit. Yeah, so yeah, I don't know what happened to Gucci. He disappeared for some time. But what I heard from Gucci was Gucci would save fucking photos of fucking people, you know, like, and keep stash it in a fucking folder or something. Like from beginning of the time on FlirtChat, I think she had photos of fucking Jewish Luna's photos when she was fucking 15 years old, and she fucking still has them. Why am I saying she? Gucci's a guy. Yeah. Gucci, no, Gucci's a dude. I don't know why I'm saying that. Listen, Gucci has photos of a lot of fucking people, you know. I don't know. He even has photos of me, like, from fucking old age. I don't know why. I don't know. But how do you feel about that? Like, Gucci saving photos of fucking people and shit.
It's weird. He would ask me to, like, make signs for him and stuff sometimes, and I was okay with it. But the one thing I wasn't really okay with is that he had these weird-ass friends in his Spanish chats, and they would come to flirt and harass me with my pictures.
Yeah, I know, but I you know,
and Gucci was like, "Oh, you need to stop talking to them. You need to stop going to those chats with me." And I'm just sitting there, like, it's literally your fault they're harassing me. You give them my pictures.
Right. No, I know about, like, Gucci has a long history of saving photos. I feel like Gucci's gonna come back to flirt one day and just, I don't know. Gucci's just fucking, I don't know, man.
My friend and all, but like that just didn't sit right with me.
So you're close with Gucci? Like, you guys talk outside of that on social media or something? Friends? Like,
yeah, we do sometimes.
Oh, really? So you talk to Gucci what, like, on fucking Facebook and shit?
Yeah, Instagram.
Wow. And okay. Wow, I didn't know you and Gucci were that close. I mean, wow, that's fucking crazy. You guys are on social media. Okay. So, because Gucci's out there in Mexico. So is Gucci trying to, I don't know, is Gucci trying to hook up with you or something? I don't know. Like, is he trying to come see you or trying to get a U.S. citizenship? Because he doesn't have a green card and he's in Mexico. He's trying to come to America. Like, you guys, I don't know.
No, he's never viewed me like that. He views me the same way you do, like a little sister in a way.
Right, but no, but Gucci has, but yeah, but I don't save your photos though. Like, I don't fucking save anybody's fucking photos. You know, I used to get it from fucking Gucci. I remember this fucking dipshit Sanders would talk shit and to fucking Coke about me, and I don't know. I was like, what does this fucking Sanders guy look like? So I would always go to Gucci. I'm like, Gucci, you got a photo of fucking Sanders? And I found out this fucking dipshit doesn't even have he's fucking balding. Like, he doesn't have a fucking hairline. Like, it's receding all the way back to his head. Like, so I was like, what the fuck, you know? I would only go to Gucci for, like, I would use Gucci. Like, I don't know. Gucci was a little weird. I don't hate Gucci, but I just thought it was weird that he had fucking photos of Luna, Jewish Luna, when she was 15. Like, I just thought that was not cool at all. Other than that, I don't have problems with Gucci at all. Like, I think Gucci's all right, but just chill out with the photos, bro. That's all. So I heard, you know, your relationship with Gucci, you guys are cool. So tell me about someone else, like, you talked to on and off on Zat or anyone.
The only three people I can think of the moment is Green Apple Ethan and,
Green Appleton?
No, Lynn Green Appleton. Fuck no, not Leanne.
I have no fucking idea who Green Apple is. I've heard of her or him. I don't know who the fuck that is. Oh, you talked to Anton, you said. Yeah, I know Anton.
Anton pops up around, like, once a year or something.
Like, you know, he was in my...
He DM'd me on Instagram the other fucking day, and I linked him your server. And then, like, he dipped and blocked me and everyone else. I'm just like, the fuck? Why would you do that?
Yeah, so what I heard from Lauren, I don't know if you know who Lauren is, from JB Zone. Her podcast is going to be out, by the way. She was actually really cool with Anton. She told me that he moved on He's got kids and family. That's what I heard. But he's pretty much moved on from Zen. Yeah. I met Anton. He was like some of the first people I met on Flirt. Him, fucking Chucky, and Zen, and all these people. So, you know, see, I didn't write any questions down. I'm just like, you know, just this is probably second time I'm speaking to you. Third time, I don't know. So tell me some more of your experiences on that, like Flirt or whatever. Good and bad experiences, some shit that happened that we don't know about, you know.
I mean, there's more bad than good. I mean, there's a lot of good experience I had, like with trolling with friends and crap. And then there's like bad experiences with like Sin or Queasy, and honestly a lot. Like Cassius is also one of them, believe it or not.
Cassius?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember this guy, Cassius. When he quit Zed, he gave me all of his fucking powers. He's like, Altair, I like you. Here's the powers. Goodbye. So look, let me ask you. So is there someone, you said there's a couple of people still who are bothering you on Zed till this day. I noticed that sometimes you come on and there's like a fucking tune, dickhead. He's gonna call you by your name, like Sheila. And I don't mean to dox you. I can edit this shit out if you want me to. But is that Sin, or is that someone you know?
That's Sin. So that's actually not my real name.
No. It was okay. You don't have to. You don't have to tell me your real name. I don't want to know. It's okay.
Oh, I'm not going to. I'm just saying Sheila was part of my reg name when I first came to Zat, and so like he just calls me that, even though it's not my real name.
Oh, okay. So the dipshit thinks that's your real name. Okay. What a fucking idiot. Shit. All right, Zolly. So let's talk about, you know, I want to go back to your views on fucking people like minorities and shit. So you're cool with fucking Latinos, right? Hispanics and Latinos and shit.
It depends.
Okay.
I don't fuck with like the Mexican Americans. They're fucking annoying, but there are some people from like Mexico that are cool, I guess, and from other Latin countries. Like I've met a lot of them. Of course, some of them are fucking weirdos because of their fucking, you just consent shit and all that, but some of them are cool. I met some cool ones from like Spanish chefs and all that. In real life, the ones like the Mexicans I personally went to school with, they're fucking annoying and I don't like them. And there's a lot of them here, so like.
Right, they're all fucking weird, right? They're all fucking. How's your So let me ask you: are you do you identify yourself as a Republican, a Democrat? Like, what do you?
Views from both. I wouldn't really fit myself into one.
Did you like Trump when he was president?
I like Trump. But like, I don't like his fucking shit. He has a sex trafficking and all that. I mean, he's a cool president despite that.
How did you feel about Trump? You know, he wanted to deport all illegal Mexicans back to Mexico. Like, how did you feel about that? Like, was that a good thing?
I actually agree with that because if you're here without a green card, you're basically a criminal. So you should go the fuck back where you came from.
Right. I agree. You know, like my family, I have family from Spain and Puerto Rico. Like, do you think like if I was illegal Puerto Rican, I should go back to Puerto Rico? And Puerto Rico is like the 51st state of America, you know?
Well, no, because I don't know. I feel like you're mixed with like a bunch of crap, so I wouldn't like, I don't know.
Right. No, I totally hear you. Do you think I should go, you know, because my grandmother was Jewish. She was from Spain. Do you think I should go back to Spain?
Well, no, I don't think that.
Okay. Yeah, I honestly don't. I think I should have wrote down fucking questions because I'm real fucking high right now and I'm just like going with whatever comes in my head and, you know, like, fuck, dude. I don't know. You know, you got something to say? Is there something you want to talk about? Is that pertaining to that? Somebody you just want to talk about, or you want to talk about something about politics? I don't know. Is there something you want to discuss or?
I don't really fuck with a lot of politics. That's probably up Achilles' area.
Achilles. Okay. All right. Let's talk about Achilles. Okay. Tell me about Achilles. Like, he comes in on Zet, right? He'll come on for literally like 10, 20 seconds once a day or once a week. And he'll type a fucking paragraph about Democrats being KKK, and then he'll praise Trump, and fucking Trump lost, and he's still talking about this shit. How do you feel about Achilles? Like, do you think the guy is a weirdo? You know, like, what do you think?
He's definitely a weirdo. Like, I honestly, there's some stuff that he says that I agree with, but then other times it's hard to take him serious because the type of shit he does and says. Like, he has a video on his YouTube talking about how he shit himself because his brother attacked him on the toilet. And it's just like, who's the fuck trying to take this guy serious?
Okay. Yeah, so he took a shit in his pants. Okay. Right. I mean, I've done that a couple of times. I'm in my 30s. I've done it. That's why my mom wants me to get out the house. And she was like, I'm a grown-ass fucking man on Zat fucking doing podcasts. Like, my mom's like, get out the house already. You know, I sometimes, you know, look, I've taken a shit in my pants. You know, it just happens. It's normal. It happens.
Yeah, but this dude shit on the actual, like, floor.
Right. Yeah, that's pretty...
A nasty-ass shit. I also... When I came to Zat when I was 11 on, like, Justin Bieber's zone and all those chats, Achilles would PC me random-ass winks and shit.
Right.
And he would say the word suck, and it's like, oh, fuck.
What kind of links were they when he's sending you?
And not links, the wink smileys.
Okay. Yes, that's pretty fucking weird. Yeah, there's a lot of weird people. You know, I'm kind of glad you're okay. You're safe. Like, nobody's fucking bothering you on Zat, right? Like, and like, they're not like fucking doing anything crazy to you, right? Like harming you or shit like that outside of Zat.
Oh, no. The Rayne Mewtune did try to do some shit to me outside of Zat, but, like, he did it at, like, the worst timing. It's the point it didn't even fucking affect me at all. Like, during 2020 in December, he decided to, like, threaten me on my messenger and shit, being like, I'm gonna send your nudes to your entire school if you don't do as I say.
Yeah, you know.
And, like, he ended up doing that, but, like, nothing happened because he did it, like, during my Christmas break. And also, after that, my principals were out with COVID, so, like, I didn't have school.
Oh, okay.
So, like, it didn't even fucking do anything to me.
Yo, Zolly, you know you're not the first girl, like, telling me this, that you got harassed, like, you know, threatening that they're going to expose your nudes. Like, I've talked to, there's two other people I talked to in here. Do you know who Gotti is? Maddie, by any chance?
Yeah, I do.
So I spoke to her. Her podcast is going to be out on the weekend. Her session I did for an hour. She told me that someone threatened her that they were going to expose her nudes, and she was underage. And like, what the fuck? And you're not the first person. I heard it from another fucking girl. I'm not going to drop her name. You can just hear the podcast session when it comes out. She said the same thing. But with her, it got really fucking personal. So I'm just going to save it for the next episode when it comes out. Wait, I think it's fucked up that these guys are fucking doing this. You know, it's fucking exposing nudes and threatening to call your school and your friends and family and sharing your nudes with them. Like, that's fucking weird, dude. Like, get fucking laid. You know, like, fucking go out. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? You know, what is wrong with these people, Zolly? What are they doing?
I know. I think the saddest part is apparently he did it all on Christmas Day. So I'm just like, do you not have friends and family that you can spend your fucking holiday with? You're just going to go and do this, bro?
Right.
Like, they must be that fucking miserable.
People are fucking weird on Flirt, dude. You know, I've trolled a lot. You know, I've said some fucked up shit too, right? But you know that I was trolling. Like, you know, I'm not about like pedo or shit. Like, I was trolling about, you know, I made a fucking comment on Flirt. I want to ask you, I don't know if you ever seen me troll on Flirt chat. Like, when I'm fucking really going at people. Like, I say shit
I do. Like, the LGBT narcissistic thing, I seen that.
Yeah, I okay, you know, being an incel and I just troll, like, okay, it's not serious. So I made a fucking comment. Like, I said that I wanted to be a transgender. I wanted to become a woman and experience womanhood. An actual transgender in the chat got really angry with me. And they wanted to, I don't know, they just wanted to fuck with me so bad. They're still upset about it. Do you know that I'm permanently banned on Zat Help? Like, my account is permanently banned. Last month was Pride Month. I went into Zat Help. I'm like, hey, guys, I need help. I'm a transgender, and I'm being bullied on Flirt Chat. I got banned for 0 hours. That means forever. So, I mean, it's not even that serious, bro. Like, just, it's a fucking joke, you know? Like, I fucking made a fucking joke, and someone got really upset with me, and they messaged me privately. They're like, hey, fucking Jose, what's up, bro? You know, I said that, you know, because with the whole abortions thing, I'm like, we need to ban abortions and legalize rape. Like, it was a fucking joke. It was a joke. It's not to be taken seriously. I didn't mean any of it. But this person got really upset with me, and they're like, they're going to fucking come for me. And they're using my real name, by the way. They're calling me by my first name, and they're really upset about it. I'm like, bro, chill out. It's not that serious. But I think I don't know. Flirt is just Flirt, you know. It's trolling. So
was it Rayne doing that?
I don't know, but I suspect it was Rayne. Okay. You know, since you mentioned Rayne, tell me about your relationship with Rayne. Do you still, like, why was Rayne DMing me 1,000 messages about you? Like, no disrespect to Rayne, because Rayne is going to listen to this. If you listen to the podcast and read the comments, all you're going to see is a bunch of comments from Rayne. So I'm not coming at you, Rayne, if you listen to this, but Zolly, tell me about your relationship with Rayne.
I think Rayne's a fucking idiot. Like, I didn't even know who the fuck he is. I guess he's new or something. He just, like, came to Flirt a few months ago. I'm just like, who the fuck is this guy? And he was saying all this bullshit about pedophilia and all that. And what gets me is that he says all this shit, calls other people pedos. But he literally roleplays with Insomniac in PC. And apparently he was roleplaying as a 14-year-old girl with him. So it's just like, how are you going to call other people pedophiles when you're enabling one by role-playing with him? It's fucking weird and stupid.
Okay, so Rayne was pretending to be a 14-year-old girl and role-playing with Insomniac.
Yep.
Like, I don't know. I don't know what to say to that. I mean, I'm pretty sure Rayne is listening. I'm like, Rayne, do you want to explain that in the comments in the below? Rayne, if you're listening to this, can you explain why were you doing this? How do you feel about Insomniac? I hear a lot of things about this guy. I heard that he's married in real life and he has kids.
Yeah, he's married to some fat fuck in real life and he has like 3 kids with her.
Right.
Yet goes on Zat and cuffs people in PC and shit and role plays with them. He does it when they're underage too, and it's just really disgusting. It's like, go fuck your wife or something instead of coming on here.
Yeah, I came on as a... I came on as a girl one time, right? I put in my fucking name. I can't even remember. I think it was fucking Michelle or something. 15-year-old girl, that was my fucking name. I got fucking messages from like 5-6 tunes. Like, hey, what's up? How you doing? Bro, that's gotta be fucking Insomniac. I mean, my name, like, I came on a fucking tune. Like, Bad Girl Jessica, she has that fucking tune with the fucking red dress and red lipstick. And it was fucking 15-year-old girl, and I got a bunch of fucking messages, bro. Yo, these guys were fucking flirting with me, and I felt so fucking weird. I felt like I was being sexually harassed and shit. Like, I'm pretty sure Insomniac was one of them. But they wanted to role play, and that... Yeah, so I don't know why Insomniac is doing this. If he has a wife and kids, why are you on Zat flirting with fucking underage girls, you motherfucker? Have some fucking shame, you fucking dickhead. You have a fucking wife and kids, you faggot. Like,
yeah, for his kids. Like, he's doing that shit on Zat. What the fuck is he doing to his kids, I wonder?
Right. How old is the guy? Do you know, by any chance?
Shit, he's at least in his 30s.
He's in his 30s, okay. Wow. And he has kids. I feel bad for his kids. Insomniac, you're listening to this, you fucking faggot. You got a fucking wife and kids, bro. Like, what are you doing? All right, Zolly, I'm real fucking... I got to go back inside the house. I'm in my yard. Okay. So listen, before I wrap this up, is there... You know what? There's one more thing I want to ask you, but you don't have to answer it if you don't want to. Just quickly, how's your relationship with Memory Lane? And did he send you any money? And if he did, like, did he get anything in return? You know?
He did send me money. I didn't really send anything in return because, like, he didn't really ask for anything in return. I was cool with him, but then, like, all of a sudden he DM'd me and said something about me, like, talking shit about him on a podcast, which I didn't do and stuff, and he, like, left Discord.
Right. I know he sent Chelsea money, too. I don't know if you know. You know Chelsea, right?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, Chelsea came on the chat and she said that Memory Lane sent her $30, I think. It was $30. She was showing receipts and she's like, she just randomly sent it and she didn't give him anything, no feed pics or nothing. I don't have a problem with Memory Lane, by the way, but I think the guy just, I mean, I think he could do a lot better in his life. I think he can change and become a better person. I think that he could do good, you know, if he wants to. You know, I think he can definitely find himself a girlfriend. I think he can become a really cool dude. So that's my advice to Memory Lane if he's listening to it. No hate. So, you know. All right, Zolly. So any last minute comments before we go?
Yeah, I just want to say fuck Rayne, fuck Philip, and fuck Wheelchair Mike. That's all.
Right, right. All right, guys, you heard it, you know. All right, Zolly, take care.
And you nice too.
Take care.